Hello guys, welcome back to my channel DC Study IQ. So in this video we are going to discuss about Ramsar site. As you know, recently 10 new sites are also added in the Ramsar site in India. So I am expecting one question from this part in RRB and TPC exams. So this topic is very important, so I'm not wasting time. Let's get into the video. So first, what is Ramsar Convention? It is a convention of wetlands. And second point, it is a intergovernmental treaty, that is a treaty between two governments of different countries. Okay, the convention was adopted in the city of Iran in 1971 and came into force on 1975. Initially, there were 27 Ramsar sites, and recently 10 more sites are added, so total 37 sites are present as of now, that is June 2020. Next topic is Montreux Record. So it comes under the Ramsar Convention. It is a register of wetlands sites on the list of wetlands on international importance where changes in the ecological character have occurred, are occurring, or likely to be occurred as a result of technological development and other human interfaces. Means idoru wetland inde register aanu appo idile include cheyidirikkunnathu wetlands aanu adayathu ecologically changes sambhavichatho sambhavichukondirikkunnatho adho sambhavikkan chance ullo thuvayittulla സൈഡ്സ് ആണ് ഈ മോൺട്രെക്സ് റെക്കോർഡിൽ നമ്മൾ ഇൻക്ലൂഡ് ചെയ്തിട്ടുള്ളത്. അപ്പോൾ ഈ ചേഞ്ചസ് വരാനുള്ള കാരണം ഒന്നുകിൽ ഹ്യൂമൻ ഇൻ്റർഫേസസ് ആവാം, പൊല്യൂഷൻ ആവാം, ടെക്നോളജിക്കൽ ഡെവലപ്മെൻ്റ് ആവാം. ഇൻ ഇന്ത്യ ആസ് ഓഫ് നൗ 2 സൈഡ്സ് ആർ ഇൻ മോൺട്രെക്സ് റെക്കോർഡ്. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് വൺ ഈസ് ക്യുഎലഡോ നാഷണൽ പാർക്ക് ഇൻ രാജസ്ഥാൻ ആൻഡ് അനദർ വൺ ഈസ് ലോക്ടെക് ലേക്ക് ഇൻ മണിപ്പൂർ. And Chilika Lake, that is in Odisha, which is removed from the Montreux record. That is, initially Chilika Lake was there in the Montreux record, and not recently, it is removed from the Montreux record. Clear? So let's look at the different Ramsar sites in all over the India. First, in Kerala there are 3 Ramsar sites. One is Ashtamudi Wetlands, second is Shastangota Lake, third is Vembanad Kayal. These 3 wetlands are included in Ramsar Convention on 2002. Almost all the South Indian wetlands are included in the Ramsar Convention in 2002. I repeat, not every wetlands, almost. Okay, moving to next slide. In Tamil Nadu there is only one wetland which is included in the Ramsar Convention, that is Point Kalimeru on 2002. And in Andhra Pradesh, Kolleru Lake. Actually spelling was wrong, Kolleru, Kolleru Lake on 2002. Okay, moving to next slide. In Madhya Pradesh, Bhoj Wetlands, that is also included in 2002. And in Odisha, there are 2 wetlands. One is Bhitarkaniga Mangrove National Park, included in 2002. And second one is Chilika Lake. which is the largest lagoon lake in India. That is included in 1981. This is important. You may note it down. 1981, Chiliga Lake was included in Damsar site. And in West Bengal, there are two. One is East Calcutta Wetlands, and second is Sundarban Wetlands. And again, Sundarban Wetland is important. That is included in 2019. Important. Note it down. And in Gujarat, only one wetlands, that is Nal Sarovar Bird Sanctuary, included in 2012. And in Rajasthan, there are two wetlands. One is Keweladio Gana National Park, which is initially known as Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary. That is included in 1981. And second one is Sambar Lake, which is the highest salinity lake in India, included in 1990. And in Punjab, there are three wetlands. Actually, there are six wetlands as of now. Three sites are included in 2019 that we will discuss in the last slide. But as of now, first one is Harige Lake, 1990, and Kanyili Lake, included in 2002, and Rubar Lake, which is included in 2002. If you are a Malayali, you can note it like this: Hariga and Ruba, Kanyakumari, Punjab Lake Poi. This is the trick to remember these sites. Okay, again, Hariga and Ruba, Kanyakumari, Punjab Lake Poi. Okay, moving to the next slide. In Himachal Pradesh, there are three wetlands. One is Pong Dam Wetlands, included in 2002. Second one is Renuka Wetland, included in 2005. Third is Chandetal Wetland, which is included in 2005. And in Jammu Kashmir, there are four wetlands. One is Molar Lake, which is the largest freshwater lake in India, included in 1990. Second one is Somoriri Lake, included in 2002. Third one is Surinsar Manasar Lakes, included in 2005. And fourth one is Hokkera Lake, included in 2005. In Assam, there is only one wetland included in the Ramsar sites, that is Dipor Bell, included in 2002. And in Uttar Pradesh, recently six more sites are included that we will discuss in the last slide. And as of now, total seven wetlands are included in the Ramsar sites. And first one is Upper Ganga River, included in 2005. In Manipur, only one wetland are included in the Ramsar site, that is Loktak Lake. Very important, it is included in 1990. And in Tripura, only one wetlands are included in the Ramsar site, that is Rudra Sagar Lake, included in 2005. And these are the newly added 10 Ramsar sites. So let's have a look one by one. So first one is Bias Conserve Reserve, which is in Punjab, added in 2019. As you know, Bias is the tributary of Indus. You can remember that, related to the Indus River. And Nangal, wildlife sanctuary that is also in Punjab. And you can relate Nangal with the Dangal film acted by Aamir Khan. Okay. And third one is Kishapur Miani Conserve Reserve. That is also in Punjab. And next one is Nandur Madameshwar, which is in Maharashtra. And last six, all are included in the Uttar Pradesh. Okay. First one is Sandy Bird Sanctuary. And second one is Saman Bird Sanctuary. Third one is Samaspur Bird Sanctuary. And fourth one is Parvati Agra Bird Sanctuary. And fifth one is Sarsai Navar Jheel. And last one is Nawab Ganj Bird Sanctuary. Okay. From the last 10 bird sanctuary, 6 are in Uttar Pradesh, 1 is in Maharashtra, and 3 are in Punjab. So that's all in this video. I am repeating again, I am expecting one question from this topic in RRB and TPC exams. So all these sites, that is 37 sites, you need to remember in order to score 1 mark in the RRB and TPC exam. If you like this video, please like the video. And if you want this kind of informative videos, please subscribe to my channel. And if you have any doubts, please comment down below. Thank you. Thanks for watching.